Aung San Suu Kyi's security detail has had to protect the visiting politician from enthusiastic supporters in Melbourne. More than 1,000 of Melbourne's Myanmar community gathered to hear Ms Suu Kyi speak.
There was a party atmosphere at the Dandenong Basketball Centre well before Aung San Suu Kyi arrived. When she did appear, security guards had to keep excited supporters at bay. This event was always going to be in Burmese, but she opened with some words for everyone.
Everywhere I've been in Australia, I've been met with great warmth and kindness, and this is something that we truly appreciate.
She then answered questions from the audience, but there was a clear theme to everything she said. In Myanmar, there are at least 7 clear ethnic groups, and the divisions between those groups have caused the country immense problems in the past. Aung San Suu Kyi's speech here was directed at all of them. She called for unity, unity amongst all the groups, whether they live in Myanmar or if they live here in Australia. It was a message that had a rousing response.
We love Aung San Suu Kyi. She is our idol. She is our hero.
We trust in her, so in the next election, the country will be changed.
Some from the Rohingya community felt disappointed, saying they were hoping she would say more about the persecution of their people in Myanmar.
Aung San Suu Kyi is not really there talking to about for real persons.
I'm not happy.
But they were the minority, and when she left, security had even more work to do. The next appointment was Victoria's Government House to mark World AIDS Day.
More love, more affection, more compassion. You never know one day when you will need it yourself.
But while she may preach compassion and love, it's unclear if Myanmar's government will give her what she wants in return. That's changed the constitution, which currently bars her from running in the presidential elections because she's the widow of a foreigner. Iskandar Razak, ABC News, Dandenong.